I killed half the targets today. You know, I'd be like, shit, I'm staying outside this place until I've killed every one of my enemies or got 100 coins right. And he's like, the sword! He's got to be like, okay. He's like, oh, an even route! Jesus Christ, the main cache. So in the back too. What a bastard. You could have killed him in the front at least. The guy was blind anyway, but still though, you could have been like, you know, bam, in the face, right? Like, nice. Do you want to have bigger boobs? Come on. You want some improvement? Buster Blade. yeah, clothes style. Yeah, this is that FF7 there. It's so hot. God damn it, this summer. It's so incredibly hot, right? I mean, I understand why Claire is sweaty all the time in the end, but this is how I have to live too, guys. So yeah, I can really feel how Claire constantly sweats, right? Constantly, because I was out now running in the woods before I was episode, right? Getting warming up for my battle in the forest, in the mountain range, all right? And Jesus Christ, it's so much sun. It is so much sun. But anyway, Gleipnir episode something something, episode 11. And I guess I have a little archer, right? Gonna be some oppies. So one don't know. It's Netherrealm guy died. I think that was funny. That was hilarious. He's like, oh, I'm gonna betray them. I died. Yeah, I was like, yeah, that wasn't very intelligent. Claire, of course, psychopathic Claire, awesome, right? Killed them all with her poisonous flowers. I love Claire's, as I said last week in the review, how she's utilizing everyone's powers. She's like, oh, you have plant power? I can utilize that in a great way. This is awesome, right? And Allah, she was like, oh, that guy, he's doing kind of nakama friendship shit. He's gonna die. He has the weakness of friendship. So yeah, she's utilizing, you know, the classic, usually the good stuff in anime. And that was awesome. Anyway, let's start watching it. So 3, 2, 1, and go. Anime time. And yes, check out my Persona 5 review right links below. I just published that today. Took my long time, 2.5 hour review, so it's a serious, of course, metal culture review. All the waifus. Yeah, so did she, the whole mammoth thing, that he was with her. Yeah, bastard alien. You have to skip in the opening because they're doing like credits now when they're talking here. I think they're skipping the opening given the credit list. Yeah, not people have died because they keep fighting in this hot, steamy mountain range. Ooh, the power she's sick. He seems to be turned on by them killing each other. It's like, oh yeah, your powers, girl! Amazing powers! Yeah, and your sister is crazy, she's awesome. Okay, here we go. She's gonna be like, don't talk about my sister. Yeah, what if you kill the alien? Good point. What if I kill the alien? What if I kill the alien? Will that, like, fix it? And he's like, yeah, I'm a human. I can die now, probably. He's no, it's possible. Okay. Ta-da. Okay. But yeah, you can't revert time, I guess, if you kill him. Yeah. She's gonna cry and so on. But I mean, she did something to his. I don't know, but it's clear that she was. There's something with his brain and he doesn't remember her. It seems that they actually. Because if you know, Furry Girl was like, I know he loves you or something. So it was like. There's a kind of mystery there, right? That he actually used to date her or something, but he doesn't remember. Maybe she wished him to forget about their relationship. This could be a thing, right? Yeah, so they killed all those monkey people. The gorilla and his ugly people. I have to say it's a little cliche, right? That everyone except the samurai, blind samurai guy, was ugly monsters. Like, the whole team of the gorilla guys were all, like, ugly, you know, grotesque Attack on Titan guys. Yeah, they were all, like, freaking ugly. They have no, like, you know, sexy. They were no, like, you know, lesbian or no, like, furry girl. Or they had nothing of, like, sexy girls. They only had, like, ugly, you know, really ugly monster strides. This here is, like, a freaking harem team. Claire! Yeah, Olander poison. Yeah, let's kill them if they survive. We should kill them. Come on, Claire, we're gonna stab them in the line. I was like, I'm gonna kill them. Or we kill them. I think you should kill them. I feel killing them is better. Go into the forest and like stab, stab, stab. or shoot, I guess, with his gun. But yeah, you know what I mean. I mean, no. Yeah, he's almost that guy, you know. Everyone, please don't kill anyone more. Minna-san. And I definitely, the invisible girl is a lesbian too. Yeah, I think she's also into... he's dead. I like last week, they didn't even talk about him. They were like, everyone survived, woo! And they were like, yeah. And then ended. Yeah, they didn't even talk about that he's gone. So they actually do care about him now, I guess. I guess they do care about him now. I was disappointed that they care about him now, because last week it was like they ignored he died. It was like they just like, did he die? Oh. But shouldn't she know though? Shouldn't the Yuri girl, Captain Yuri, shouldn't she know that she killed him? Okay, so they are dating, right? Come on, they are. She was clearly getting off, frustrated, touching her hand before. And now sitting here talking to each other after the battle. I don't know why they're going back to the town all the time. I don't know when they have time to go out and into the town. I think you keep, going up the mountain range. Like, why are they going back down again every second episode? That to me is really strange. Yeah, see? She's lesbian. She's also lesbian. Look at this. She's like, hey, girl. Ooh! Oh, yeah. She's like, she knows that she's affectionate for her. Yeah, I mean, they're clearly girl on girl. Come on. Do it! We clearly watched this anime because I want to see the kiss, come on, or something. Come on! But yeah, she works at her workplace, of course. She works at her place there. She basically goes to her girlfriend's work there, come on. And they are maybe boy on boy. Ooh, that could be an interesting way. So we see those girls, and it's like, ooh! It is a boy love scene. I mean, that guy is very bishonen, right? That other guy is like a very... I mean, this guy is clearly a bottom, right? He's clearly an uke. Yeah, he takes it, yeah. He's clearly that guy. Yeah, he fails, so he's like this, yeah. How did she do it? You psychopath girl! I can clearly see this going the yaoi route, definitely. I mean, two pretty boys together, definitely. Yeah. He's always been weird. He didn't like my flowers. I know he's weird. I gave him flowers and he didn't like them. But yeah, he remembers him as a kid, right? But he doesn't remember. So it's something, like I said last week, right? It's something with him actually. I think he actually dated Elena, right? He dated her probably, right? And he doesn't remember it. So something like that, right? As he said there, he didn't remember me from the kid thing. Maybe a kid's old class, I don't know, at that hentai school. I could see, maybe, there's a PTSD, maybe. Maybe he killed them all, maybe he did something here. Maybe he isn't actually an innocent little, bystander guy. Maybe he's actually a complete psychopath too. Maybe he's a horrible murderer, right? But I don't see how he would do it, though, when he was a kid. Unless he like poisoned them or something. I don't know, Claire, you always do this. Yeah, so he has like a dark side, deep. Yeah, here we go. Yeah. My memory has no... There's something dark inside of me. It's like, I remember. Yeah, here we go. Maybe he's gonna remember his true evil side here. I'm actually evil. It would be a nice twist if the main thing. He's kind of the typical, I'll say, he's kind of that typical scaredy main character, right? The, oh no, I'm afraid. It'd be kind of interesting if he turned out to actually be a complete lunatic as well, right? He's like, yeah, I killed everyone in my class when I was 5. I stabbed my sensei, and then, I was like, ah. It would be an interesting twist to it. He's even worse than Claire. He's like, whoa, I killed them all and I liked it. Oh, nice. She's just like a... Ooh, itchy! Ooh! Itchy! What? Why is... Ah, yeah, I left her around. You did with the helmet. You are unfair. She was naked. I want to be naked too. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. You were naked with her, but not with me. See, but that's just, I feel stupid in the story though. They didn't know back at school, and she's like, "Hey guys," and hanging out at school because we know that like, it's like every second person in the whole school is a monster and the town generally. So how can they go into the forest, kill like 10 people, and then like, let's go back to town again? Because the guy with the shovel is a pub master, right? The girl at the green store isn't their team, but still, you know, everyone in this freaking place is like a monster, or more or less, right? So I would not go back to school just casually be like, "Hey guys, I killed half the town yesterday." You know, I would be like, "Shit, I'm staying outside this place until I've killed every one of my enemies or got 100 coins, right? Until I won the game, I wouldn't just go back living at school where I can't trust anyone not to kill me at that time, right?" And I think it's stupid, honestly. I think the worst thing with the whole plot here is that there's no fight at school yet. Why isn't anyone trying to kill them at school? Why hasn't no one attacked this girl at school yet, right? Why is every fight outside of school inside the forest? Why is everyone going into the sweaty, hot forest? Why is no one ever trying to kill anyone in the city? Is there some kind of unwritten law in this anime that you can't fight in the city? Is like, is ever agreed on that I'm an evil monster, but I won't kill anyone in the city? And also, you know, the half of the monsters are very, you know, R-ist, right? They're very into R-ing. So why aren't they R-ing their classmates and so on at school or whatever, right? You know. I'm just saying. Why are they still here at school? Exactly. Where's that guy? Clearly a monster. See, this guy makes sense. The other guy, he's has to go back to school yet. Yeah, that makes sense. That he's like, "I'm not going to go back to school." Because he's probably dead or he's one of the bad guys. Yeah, so because you probably killed him. Or he's one of the other guys that we, of course, has powers. Yeah, some sketchy guys. See? And of course, as I say, right, that's why I wouldn't go back to school. Now, so finally someone's like, "Oh, there's a lot of dead bodies." Actually, they killed like a dozen people. So, did I kill my friend? But yeah, but I mean, they have, this at least like, you know, they killed like 10 people at least. So wouldn't they have like a lot of dead classmates or, not classmates, but you know, generally school students, right, would be dead, right? Did I kill my classmate? Probably. Or he's one of the other bad guys in the other group, right? We saw him. Yeah, it's interesting. Why? About my memory. But they should have coins. He could have used a coin to ask him to fix memory. Okay, interesting. He screams so loudly that everything... Ah, that's the clearly... I said last week that the samurai guy or whatever, the sword guy, he was gonna survive, right? The blind guy with the blind thing and the katana, which must be Apokawa, then, yeah. I said he was gonna survive, right? I said that guy clearly looked too interesting to die in the flames, right? So that guy, of course, survived the poison flame thing. Ooh, interesting. I can depower you. Well, they're like altered humans. But yeah, I mean, she seems to actually be like a genuinely good person, right? The leader. Like, she seems to be a genuinely nice individual, right? But this team, I mean, they were all ugly monsters except that guy. The only guy that was an ugly monster is this guy with the katana, yeah. The rest of them are like ugly, you know, hentai monsters, right, that likes to R people, yeah, like, they're all of them, looks like, you know, typical, yeah, that kind of genre, yeah. Well, I think he's gonna be alive, though, he could be one of the other guys, another teams. Well, he clearly doesn't have your feelings. He's enjoying it. He's like, "Oh, what a cool power you have." He's enjoying it. He's like, "Hey, hey." He's just enjoying them fighting and struggling and so on. Clearly. But I think he can use one coin to ask him for lost memories. Wouldn't that just be one coin? It's like, "Here's one coin. Give me back my memories." You don't need 100 coins to get the memories back. You need 1 coin for that. If I understand the powers correctly, you can just give fix your brain for that, right? I don't know, he seemed to be enjoying it primarily. But this is not the only alien from the... Every coin's like an alien, right? Every coin's like the power of... Something like that, right? It's like a memory card of prey, right? It's like a disc of an alien memory, or personality, or whatever. Yeah, so... If we say we, right? But okay, so this is gonna fight the sword guy then, because I mean, clearly the sword guy was hiding behind the wall there, and yeah, there he is, yeah. And he killed the survivor. As I said it last week, he's gonna survive, because he looks way too special, right? He looks way too... But everyone else, right, in the whole... Yeah, look at them. They're all ugly, fugly monsters, right? They all are, you know, freaking ugly monsters. Katana guy, only guy that didn't look like a monster. Of course he's gonna survive. Yeah, he's like, come on, let's fight, boy. Let's fight, boy. So yeah, so there we go. It feels very predictable. I have to say that, bro, because he's the only guy that didn't look like a monster. I wonder if he's blind with the powers and he can see something like, I don't know, Ilan. I can sense people's souls. Maybe he has powers like that. But clearly that the whole blind thing is interesting. Hmm. But why are you the only guy? Am I the only one that keeps wondering? Why is he the only one that doesn't look like a monster? I don't understand. Why is he the only one in the whole group that's a human? Okay, only one survived. He's the only guy that was beautiful enough to survive. Yeah, I'm the only one left. Because he's the only guy that really wasn't ugly. Oh man, it's so predictable from the character design that he was going to survive. Oh. Yeah, that woman is very... that woman is best girl! I am sorry. What? He's gonna take the... Over his power shot, it's like a... I'm guessing it's a kind of, you know, I can sense anyone with my super eyes or something. His power is probably isn't the sword, right? He just happens to have a sword and has... I mean, I'm guessing his power isn't the sword. I'm guessing his power is just that he's like a human with some kind of super sense. Maybe? Maybe he can summon the sword now. I don't know, but... I feel his powers are probably like, I can sense everyone's soul or something, right? And the katana is just like an extra... Maybe he can control the sword. Maybe he can like pull like a Thor thing. It's like, come to me, Masamune! Maybe he can summon the sword now. That could be a thing. This guy might be Abukawa, though. I mean, this guy could be him transformed, right? Yeah, but he was pure evil! He kidnapped young girls or something. Maybe he's gonna get some really good. Yeah, well, he did attack people, though. It's just a weird mental state to have, because, yeah, he was evil. He didn't have to, like, kill people and that girl he killed off. Like, what's the point of that? He just killed his random girl, right? So, yeah, they were evil. Even if he protected his friends. Even if Madoka protected his friends. He's like, the sword! He's gonna be like, okay. He's like... This seems so pathetic and tragic. He's like slowly letting him pick up the katana again. He's like... and he's like very slowly moving away with the katana. He's like, he looks so pathetic. He's like, I'm gonna let him move away from me because he looks so incredibly weak. Oh, that's gonna kill him. Yeah, if he's really looking down on him, he's just shooting him. Man, he's going the evil route! Jesus Christ, the main cash. In the back too! What a bastard! He could have killed him in the front at least. The guy was blind anyway, but still though, he could have been like, you know, bam, in the face, right? Like, I'm gonna shoot him in his back. Jesus Christ, he's going full evil here. Interesting, I like it. The main character, Shuichi, is going full on evil. Love it. He's accepting his evil path here. So he probably did kill all his classmates as a 5-year-old, right? As I kept saying. This is his true form. Octopus. Tentacle style. Of course he was a hentai main character. He was straight up hentai when he... Of course he was. I think he needs to get up there. Gosh, she gave the IDs. I found the key! Huh? Oh, sorry, it's a key for, you know, the powers. Unlocking it, I mean. Oh, he doesn't like your friends, they're boring. He doesn't even like them. Does he want... He's so evil, he doesn't want to save his friends. He's like, I don't care about my friends. I just want people to evolve. Yeah. He's like, I didn't... He's his employee to have the battle. Yeah, they're piping in ass. Okay, but she really wants him to be... Yeah, you'd be alone. Hit the butcher by yourself, right? Yeah. He understands. No, he's hungry. He's hungry, you. Oh, I love it. Okay, she gives him his first gift of bread. This is way more powerful than his coins, right? Yeah, it's filled with germs. And thanks for that image. So this is a true love story of the anime here. This is the actual true love story of the anime. It's like, I will give you the power to kill people! Please let me here! I can give you body upgrades, girl! I can improve you! Do you want to have laser with your eyes? Do you want to have bigger boobs? Come on. You want some improvement? Man, she's like, I want to kill people in the forest! Yeah, this woman cursed them all. Man, she's the one giving all that is, yeah. Put a vending machine, give people powers up, make them fight in the forest, life or death, let them kill each other, it's gonna be hilarious. What's your wish then? But yeah, it's kinda cray cray. She sets it up hard here. Okay, what is it wish then? Of course you can ask for her wish, yeah. Her wish was to, I don't know, win immediately? Maybe share the water, right? Maybe everything's already finished. Yeah, she certainly wanted everyone to kill each other. That definitely was her dream. Definitely was her dream to have him has to kind of like battle Royale in the forest. Definitely, that was her dream. Yeah. Yeah, and there they are. Girl. I mean, there they are, right? Yeah, like, you know, dating, right? Yeah. So he doesn't remember dating, you know, yeah. They are dating, right, clearly. And in the review, definitely go back to that image. Hmm. Why do they all have really ugly faces for? How is it that these people are gonna die, right? Because they have no eyes, or they have no pupils. Like, why is it ugly for? If you're an ugly character, you're gonna die. Ah, there he is. One of the friends, right? Yeah, one of the original friends here. Original monsters. So clearly these guys are going to be powerful because they're the original friendship. No. And they're going to be some ugly... So I mean, clearly this guy's going to be very powerful, right? Because again, he was in the photo. Oh, here we go. Whoa. Yeah, I guess that's what she... I guess what Elena is... Whoa. Some kind of Buster Blade. yeah, Cloud style. Yeah, this is that FF7 there. It looked exactly like the Cloud Sword. The Buster, yeah. Oh, it's straight up there. I mean, come on. Where's my FF7? It's here in my... Yeah, my table there. Yeah, FF7. That looked exactly... Come on, that was the Buster. It was... Come on, it was exactly the Buster Blade. It really was. You can't tell me it wasn't. You can't tell me it wasn't like that. That was exactly the Buster Blade. Jesus Christ. That was the Buster Blade. And again, for that matter, what I'm talking about, right? Yeah, Persona 5 review out yesterday, right? There's like the ultimate waifu male cast review. It's awesome. But I mean, that blade, that was Cloud's sword. Straight up, right? But that really explains a lot of the backstory of what is happening, what is Elena and the whole, you know... Not really explains why Shuichi is... like he is, right? But it explains kind of like what she's doing, right? She's like, we have to go up there and fight and so on, right? Because of course in the image we did see the photo there. I think is the most important thing, right? The whole episode, right? Definitely. Well, and of course Shuichi going evil, but I mean generally from a kind of narrational standpoint. Let's just see. There you go. They're all really friendly. Yeah, so this thing here, right, is clearly the biggest takeaway. I'm covering the last color. So that this here is a big thing, right? That clearly shows you why she's doing her thing, I think, because yeah, this guy's up at the end, right? And they're like, yeah, we have to do that. So clearly, this girl then, right, that befriended the alien, Madoka, who started the whole thing, right? These are her friends, and of course you can see that Shuichi is part of the friend, right? And that's, you know, they were probably the first to get powers, right? Elena and so on, right? And these other people, right? So that's how they connect back to it, and why she's trying to, you know, I guess, revert what's happened and so on, right? Because she, of course, is one of the original, like, power members, right? With that thing. So that's a big thing, I feel. Definitely a big thing. That we saw that thing, for sure, right? For sure. But otherwise, though, I mean, Switch is going, like, pure evil there. He lets him just go around. He goes, like, pure evil, too. Yeah, this in here, it's like, what the hell, man? It's like, yeah, pff, and he shoots him. Yeah, and he's like, you know, he's like, yeah, I'm gonna kill you in the back. In the back, too, he's like, that really went dark there. Shuichi goes full evil darkness there. And not only that he killed him, that's one thing, right? He fights this guy and kills him in arguably self-defense, if he killed him, you know, from the beginning, right? But instead, it's like, he lets him kind of get injured, and he tries to escape. He's like, oh, can I escape? He's like, talks to her on the phone. I was like, everything is fine. Yeah, what you said, honey? I was like, hey, best girl. Yeah, that date tonight? Yeah, because like shoots him in the back while talking to Claire, right, about their date. Or, oh, I'm going to SU tonight. Yeah, I'm going to smash hard, honey bun. It's like, man, he goes full evil. And I think, I mean, the whole reason, right, but he has no memory could be, of course, because he's part of the photo bit. That's probably why. But still, though, the whole thing he doesn't remember. Specifically, doesn't remember that school thing. He probably did kill his teacher or the classmates or something, right? I mean, I say it jokingly in the last episode. Like, well, maybe he killed them, right? Half jokingly. And I was like, yeah, he probably did. So I like that twist. That he actually isn't that typical, you know, crying, whiny main character. He actually is pure evil or something. Deep down, he's some kind of evil sociopath. Dating a psychopath, and he's like, oh yeah, I'm gonna kill them all. It's like, okay. And then, yeah, I guess, you know, his friend was in the fire and died, right? But I think one thing that really undermines the whole blind katana guy storyline is that he's like, no, but Madoka and this guy and so on, Abakawa and so on, that they were actually good people, they were good to us, and we were best friends and so on, yeah. That thing, I think, is so undermined because the first thing we see them do is kill this random girl, right? It's like a random girl, and you just murder her. They like awe her, and then they kill her off, head off, right? And then the first guy we see in their team, the caterpillar orb guy, immediately tries to, of course, awe their leader, right? The innocent lesbian girl, yeah. And they immediately try to, you know, get her up high and so on. So this like, we actually aren't the bad guys. We're actually good guys, except when we keep constantly, you know, touching, you know, improperly taking ladies, and you know what I mean, yeah. So it's like, really though? And I feel that's kind of weird. I think actually, my opinion, I think it could be better written here. I mean, oh, but let's get it wrong. I like this anime a lot, but it's clearly a masterpiece, right? And I think that could have been better in that sense, because it's like, if you want me to have sympathy for your, you know, R-ist gorilla guy and his R team and so on, right? The forest R boys, like, make them be more sympathetic. Make them actually be more. They're out in the forest trying to get 100 coins. They're not trying to kill people by just doing it. They're actually trying to just get the 100 coins, right? And then this girl is like, I'm gonna kill you with my power. I want the coins. And they have to defend themselves from her. And even if they would have then armed her and so on, right, afterwards, and then killed her off, that would be evil. But it is really that she attacked them a lot more, like they're actually out eating or something. She's like, you know, I'm gonna kick your ass. Yeah, and she attacks them in the back, right? They defend themselves, and then they get her as revenge. That would have been at least like, yes, they aren't good people, but they would be a little more sympathetic, because they're like, sympathy for them would make a little more sense, right? Because like, well, she's the one that actually, you know, attacked them and so on. But instead, no, she went into that trap and then they got her, right? So it really isn't like they're innocent at all, right? And same thing there, he's trying to get sympathy by like, no, he was this guy at school, but this guy, you know, in the forest. And it's like, yeah, but in the forest, you were just kidnapping young girls, stuff like that. So you know what I mean? It just really flowed as well. They're trying to like motivate that we aren't the bad guys. We are actually a neutral party, right? It really doesn't throw it away, but it could have done. I think actually the writing could be better here if they actually were less just straight up evil, right? If they actually, because Madoka last week was saving his friends in the flame and so on, friendship, like a man, so on, right? But at the same time, that guy is a complete artist and so on, right? So it really is like, well, can we not play him off? Can it be, you know, play him off as a good guy generally then? I mean, he can still have bad, you know, general. What I mean is that he and other guys could have had, you know, they could have done bad stuff, right? But they could have done bad stuff because they're like humans and they're not perfect and so on. And they could have done bad stuff as a mean then, in this situation then, you know, as a counter, right? As like a last thing. I'm not saying that's the right thing to do. I'm just saying that would have made them, it is somewhat sympathy for them. Like they aren't bad, they are bad guys, but they're more like anti-villains, right? Or, you know, they do bad stuff, but they also might do good stuff if it fits them, right? Instead, it's like the opposite. They are really disgusting bad guys, and then but they're claiming to be good guys because they are friends with each other. He sees the same thing. Oh, but he was my friend. Yeah, it's like it doesn't play off very well. But I think a problem with that is just because the first time we see them, right, is because the first time we see them, the caterpillar guy is like, oppa, yeah. So it's played off like complete creeps, right? Because I think some older guy, like the sword guy, would have been one leader drop. I think there's a problem with the anime generally, that the sword guy is only about to survive, was so predictable, he's the only guy that looks pretty. He's the only pretty guy. But anyway, here's the course of Yuri moments. He's like, let me hit this. You want me to hit it up, girlfriend? No, I can't use your body every day. She's like, no, we are doing it every night, honey. I feel like I'm taking advantage of your horniness, yeah. Oh no. So yeah, there's a lot of lesbian in the anime. There's a lot of girl and girl. Yeah, there's a lot of they have a higher percentage of LGBT characters than usual, but it's a very hentai anime, so I guess no wonder. But yeah, I mean, she's literally like, want me to heat you up? But she's like, maybe a little bit, but no. We did it yesterday. We're doing it every night, my love. We're doing it too much. Yeah, we're having too much fun stuff together. We should probably stop. His power interested though, yeah. Basically, he summons, a naked babe that pulls up like a. Yeah, he summons a naked babe that pulls up, and she looks to court like the best friend she has, so his power is her in a ghost form or something, or maybe that isn't even his powers, right? Interesting. Maybe it isn't even his powers. Maybe his powers is actually, you know, something else, and she's just like a ghost or something, or his the original girl is like turned into this, like, you know, goddamn it, baby. Turn into this super, being with a cloud buster and just, you know, kills people at random. And that's why Elena also stops them. But clearly that whole thing is connected to why Elena to her stuff. And also the memory then. Why he lost all the memory. And I guess Elena... But one thing that I'm thinking about though, maybe Shuichi has two powers. Because maybe Shuichi, right, had another power before she turned him into a mascot. Maybe his power actually was different and then... She turned him into a mascot and lost his memory at the same time. So maybe he has two powers. At least he's evil now. He just killed the guy in the back. What if his power was actually? It's like blind guy? Blind guy seems so bad. It's like I can 5 feet a sword or something. But I can eat them easily anyway. So that power was weird. But anyway, that's the Gleipnir reaction review, guys. Subscribe, press the like button. Share the Persona 5 review posted this earlier today. And I'll see you guys tomorrow with Fruit Basket. Finally, after the Fruit Basket, right? So you guys have a great day.